Well, I'm here at, I think I call it EXP London, don't I? With Matt, who's one of the founders of this very new site. Explain, first of all, how what you've actually got here and what the purpose of this place is.
So what we've done at EXP-Leisure is we've created a place for any type of gamer. We've got some tabletop stuff going on. We've got some consoles.
Speaking of which, don't bang this one because the camera's going all over the place.
VR stuff, consoles, as I said, some PC stuff. We're looking to accommodate any sort of gamer. So whether you're someone who's only played Monopoly before, we've got plenty of those. If you're someone who is a bit more hardcore and wants to play something such as the new games with things like Blood Rage, things like that, which are a bit more hardcore, a bit of a niche game, we've created somewhere that everybody can do.
And this site is right on the edge of the River Lee, and literally is a, if I panned around there, you can't really see it because it's behind the trees, but out the other side of that is the Olympic Stadium, currently now West Ham's
base. London Stadium,
And we're on the edge of, obviously, of the Olympic Park. This whole area is undergoing all sorts of refurbishment. I found it difficult to get here just because...
Through that window just there, actually, there were flats there about 4 weeks ago, and we came here one day and they disappeared.
Well, it is that new, and the same applies to you, because you guys are now 6 weeks old, I think you
said. Yeah, 6 weeks into our training, yeah.
And at the moment, I mean, you're literally kind of just finding
your feet. Yeah, so we wanted to open because we wanted somewhere that people could come to and join in with the building of it. We didn't want to create somewhere that someone then came in and said, have you got this? And we said, no, not gone for that. We wanted somewhere that come in, people could suggest things, come in with ideas, bring things in themselves. A lot of the people who've come in to use us have then said, could I bring this in, could I bring that? And we've gone, absolutely. If it's something that's to do with gaming or anything related, that's something we want to work with people with.
What makes it slightly unusual is that it's a combination of both traditional board games, which, as we both know, are facing a huge resurgence of interest. And there's a place we've just been talking about up the road in Haggerston, which is just dedicated. It's a cafe, board game cafe, and it does more business than you could possibly hope. In fact, they can't even get them in there. They have licensing difficulties. So that's the board game, but you've got also the online gaming.
Yeah.
You've got local area network gaming.
Yeah, so we've got a bit of local area network. What we seem to find is, as you just said, there's plenty of places for board gamers to go. Plenty of pubs will say, yeah, we can accommodate you on this night or that night or another night. So we knew there was a market for that. Being a console gamer, because I'm in that generation of that's what we grew up with, there aren't a lot of places where you can go and just do console gaming. There's a place called the Loading Bar in London. I can't remember which station it's closest to, but they have a few consoles, a few retro stuff, and they have a VR booth. So we know there was that, but we wanted to create somewhere where we could do tournaments, we could host plenty of people, rather than say maybe 10, 11, we were somewhere you could host maybe 50, 60 people on a regular basis.
And you have got both up-to-date consoles, Xboxes,
so we've got
and
Xboxes,
Sony PlayStations,
PS4s,
but you've also got
a lot of retro stuff as well. At first we had the PS4s and had the Xboxes, we've increased the number we've had of those, but a lot of people came in and said, we need N64s, you need GameCubes, and we were like, brilliant, wrote those down. I think within about 2 weeks after someone suggested it, we'd gone from, I think, maybe one retro console to maybe now six or seven-ish. And we're still looking to increase that in terms of, first of all, the games library for each and the number of consoles we've got.
Because they'll go into the room that's effectively behind us, which is a great big cavernous
space,
kind of hall. And they'll have lots of bean bags like these ones here. And that'll fill that whole room. You'll also have a virtual reality booth in there.
Yeah, so we've spoken to a company called Vertigo. They're based in Wapping, and they're almost the same as us. They're a destination bar. And we spoke to them through Dino PC, which is a computer company, one of us, a relatively new one, but they're one of the only ones that's based in London. So we went to them for a bit of help a few weeks ago, and they suggested Vertigo, who have three virtual reality booths that are coming in soon with a big screen as well. So We can stream some of those up, and people can come and watch people play games and everything on them. So yeah,
and then the far room on the other side of that is where the local area network is, and those are sets of tables with PCs all connected up, and you can do play teamwork in there. So you can be playing things like Player Unknown's Battlegrounds at the moment, which is the hot new thing, or Overwatch, or any of those sorts of games, League of Legends, that kind of stuff. And you were talking earlier on about, you just mentioned it now, about streaming. Mm-hmm. Part of the idea is also that there will be events held here, and you were talking about a World of Tanks event.
So yes, we the first big event we've got is a Tekken 7 tournament. Mm-hmm. It's hosted by NGI Events and Bandai Namco. Mm-hmm. It's the UK London qualifiers. It's on the 14th of May. The estimated traffic is about 256 people. About 40 of those will be players, and the rest are actually people who are going to come and watch. We came to realise actually a lot of the tournaments, the number of people watching
are huge.
Completely blows out the number of people that are actually there playing. So we're estimating.
You see those big tournaments over in Europe.
In Korea, one of the stadiums for the League of Legends final, I think, had around 40,000 people watching the final. So you know there is a market for it, definitely. We've got about, I think we said 120 people are going to come and watch the final be streamed, and 40 to maybe 80 people are going to come and actually play Tekken 7.
Something we haven't talked about, but I think you're also planning to dabble in at least, is cosplay.
Yes. We're talking to people about doing some events here. We went to, one of the first things we went to when we were building EXP was the London Comic Con over at XL. And I'd never been to a Comic Con before. I'd been to Salute, which is a big board game thing, and some people do stuff for that. Didn't realise the amount of people who were going to dress
it
up.
Huge.
So a lot of Harley Quinns, obviously with Suicide coming out, a lot of people dressed as that. So we are looking to do things like, when we do our events and stuff, we are looking to have things like costume competitions. We're going to have some cosplay events here. Yes, we are looking into getting some people involved in that.
Fantastic. You're touching all the right buttons. Yeah. It's great stuff, and it is needed because there aren't that many other venues. You were mentioning one that's up the road that you're now, in effect, collaborating with, and you're expecting a sort of overspill from you to go to them and vice versa. But there aren't that many, so you're right at the at the right place. For people coming here, what's the deal? There's a membership?
We are looking to do, as I said, we're still building. Mm-hmm. The basic idea is for tabletop gaming, it's £1.50 an hour per person. Mm-hmm. So you come in, you set up, you play for as long as you want. We'd sign you in, we'd do your start time, your finish time, and then we'd settle up at the end.
Yep.
And for console gaming, it's £3 an hour, and that's the same for the PC stuff as well. But we are looking at doing things like deals for clubs, for things like unlimited gaming. And we're just starting off our Kickstarter stuff. Mm-hmm. So we put together all of our ideas. We're looking at doing some things for, depending on what sort of membership you wanted and how much you wanted to donate on Kickstarter, what sort of memberships and deals you'd get with that. So we're looking at doing sort of monthly memberships, yearly memberships, lifetime membership, things like that people can then effectively come back and play whenever they want, for how long they want, and they'll get discounts or they won't get charged because they're paying per month, sort of thing. Yeah.
And we should also say, of course, that the other important thing is that none of this goes without the basics, some food and some alcohol or tea or whatever you want.
Just behind there, we've got a small bar, and downstairs we do have the EXP Cantina. Which is fully, so it's got a menu which we're revamping.
Yep.
So we'll have a bit more food and drink on there. We've got beers, we've got draft beers, we've got a lot of stuff brewed from Truman's, a lot of sort of local stuff. And it's also actually you were mentioning the London Stadium earlier, we are actually a West Ham home fans bar as well.
Oh, cool.
So when there's a home game, we have about 500-600 fans come in, completely drink our bar dry, especially if they win. They'll go off, they'll watch the game, come back. We have barbecue every game as well. So
there's an outside area here isn't there, by the river, and as you said earlier, right at the beginning, right alongside
bar,
the river itself, just by the lock. Mm-hmm. Matt, it's a really exciting time for you. I mean, you must be absolutely jacked on this one.
Yeah, it's been really good. It's hard to take a day off.
Yeah, I bet.
It's hard to not want to know what's going on at work when I'm not here.